Greetings all, and welcome back to Star Wars The Old Republic. Went ahead and spent quite a bit of our money, and I was having a hard choice on deciding if I wanted to mod out our gun or to go ahead and upgrade Jorgen some more, so I went ahead and bought him some gifts. We got him up to level 19. While I was here, I was kind of looking around. I wanted to find the adaptive gear vendor, and I figured there might be some other people that don't know where he's at, so I'll go ahead and show that off real quick, and then we'll get started with our questing. It's all the way up top north here on the Senate Tower. Let me see if I can actually get a better map. There we go. So yeah, if you go to the Senate Plaza Taxi and head north, and there's a whole lot of vendors here that are underground. If you actually go into this side right here, the adaptive gear vendor is located right down here where we're at. So that's where that's at, and we are headed off to Tatooine to hunt down some more of the Havoc Squad traitors. So I'm going to make my way to the ship, and we will see you guys probably before we actually get to Tatooine. I think we'll probably travel that route together, so we'll see you here shortly. Welcome back. Our quest log doesn't give us a whole lot of information. It just says that we need to travel to Tatooine and contact General Garza. Let's go ahead and pull out our course here. And I'm actually going to wait here a few seconds. I've noticed that sometimes if I rush straight into the holo terminal, occasionally, and I'm sure it's probably because we're not quite there yet, I end up getting a black screen and have to back out of it and then redo
it. Lieutenant, this is General Garza. I see you've landed in Anchorhead. Tatooine is a vast and dangerous desert of a planet, and I'm afraid you can't count on having Republic support during your mission there.
Havoc Squad can handle anything.
All the same, Lieutenant, I hate sending my people into uncharted areas like Tatooine without some kind of support. In the absence of military assets, I've arranged a local contact to assist you in your mission. Oleg Claren, the mayor of Anchorhead. Mayor Claren may not be a soldier, but he knows the area extremely well and can put his city's resources, whatever those may be, at your disposal.
Sounds like a useful friend to have.
Be sure to remember that this operation is top secret, Lieutenant. I told Mayor Claren only that you're undertaking an important mission, which is all that he needs to know. Understood?
I'll proceed with caution, General.
Very good. That's all I have for you at the moment. Proceed with the operation. Garza out.
Alright, so we're not supposed to tell anybody, kind of like we did last time. We'll see what happens. If I can find the exit. There we go. Okay, so we're off to find the mayor, and this is going to be class only. We're not going to do any planetary quests or side quests here. Maybe bonus quest if it pops up, but I'm not going out of my way looking for it. Okay, where is this mayor actually located? Awesome. Now this is one side of Tatooine I haven't seen yet, so I'm anxious to explore it. I think we'll go right. Nice little parking spot there, I guess. Alright, is that clickable? No. Well, that area kind of looks dead. Well, you know what? Actually, looking out at this way, it reminds me a lot of Star Wars Galaxies. Quite a bit, actually. But, you know, Tatooine is nothing but desert, so there's a whole lot of that on Star Wars Galaxy, at least on Tatooine. There's nothing but desert. So I guess it's kind of hard to change the graphics in between those two games. Well, the graphics are different, but as far as it being a desert-type area, it looks extremely similar to Star Wars Galaxies. Okay, let's get in here and talk to the mayor.
That puts the tally somewhere around 64, sir. But we've still got some volunteers digging through the rubble, to be sure.
64? So many. So much death, and for what? Why is this happening? What have we done to deserve this?
We still don't have any leads, sir, but I'm sure... Excuse me, who are you? This is the mayor's office. You can't just barge in here without an appointment.
I'm a soldier. The mayor knows I'm coming.
You must be the lieutenant, the one General Garza told me about. I am so thankful that you're here. Please, lieutenant, I need your help. My city, the people of Anchorhead, need your help.
How can I be of assistance?
Someone is attacking us, lieutenant. Bombs have been going off all over Anchorhead, more than a dozen just in the past week. And we have no idea who's behind them. No threats, no demands or warnings. Innocent people are being murdered without any explanation.
Jorgen, isn't one of our objectives a bomb expert?
That's a big affirmative, Lieutenant. He pulled some pretty flashy stuff back on Ord Mantell, if memory serves.
Really? Do you think our problems might be related, then? If you find this bomb expert...
Sir, Mayor Clarence, sir. There's been another bombing. An apartment building over in District 7.
Oh, no. No! How many? Do we know yet?
No, sir. But it's going to be bad. A lot of people lived in the building. A lot of families.
I'll proceed to the scene at once, Mayor Claren.
After the first explosion, there are always more, all in the same area. If you hurry, you might get there in time to stop them. Please, Lieutenant, protect my people, and I'll do anything I can to help your mission. Please, hurry!
You can send a few of those droids in. I saw one walking around during the cutscene. Yeah, send a couple of those guys in there. Oh well, I guess it's our job. And we do need to hurry, so let's get over there pretty quick. Is the entrance actually on this side? Maybe right there? There she is. Oh, I saw a clicky. Water access. Okay, yeah. Not gonna mess with that. I'm pretty sure that's gonna be similar to what the Imperial side has.
What? Who's there?
Just hang in there, Bennett. I'm Kana. I'm your neighbor, remember? You're going to be okay. Just try not to move, all right?
Okay. Sure. But my leg...
Don't worry. You'll be safe now.
Hear that, Bennett? You're going to be just fine. I think I'm the only person who lives here who wasn't hurt. I was just up the street, heading for the market. One second I was walking, and the next I was face down in the street. I didn't even see the explosion. I just felt it.
You're lucky to be alive, ma'am.
Yes. If I'd have left a few seconds later, I'd still have been inside.
Droid. It was a droid. Walked in the front door, and boom, everything went white.
Hard to believe a single droid could do so much damage.
That's what I saw.
Oh no! Oh no 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 no! Over there! In the doorway!
No, in the doorway. Well, that's not in the door. That's coming up out of the ground. What's going on here?
May I speak with you for a moment?
Jorgen, get busy.
Greetings.
No, you guys stay away from me.
Gentle being?
May I speak
with you for a moment?
Nope, I don't want you speaking with me.
How may I serve you? How may I serve you?
We're all going to die!
Oh boy, how many of these guys do we gotta put up with? How about a stun? Jorgen, what?
Greetings.
Come on, Havoc Squad!
Greetings. How may I serve you?
How about some AoE? Oh boy.
It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance. How may I serve you? Greetings.
Are we done? Looks like we're done. Alright, where's the good guy at? Oh, we're gonna talk to the female. Okay.
Is it over? Are they all dead?
Don't worry. You're safe.
You did it! You really did it! We're safe! Bennett, we're safe!
Good. Good.
We owe you our lives. I wish there were some way we could repay you.
As a soldier of the Republic, it's my duty to help.
You're a true hero. I'll never forget what you've done here today. None of us will. Thanks again, stranger.
Alright, back to the mayor. I don't really feel like we did a whole lot here. I mean, we did stop the attack, but we didn't really uncover anything. Can we mount up? That will work. Yeah, it was a good story, but it needed a little bit more. We could have helped those people or something. Maybe help them rebuild a little bit or get them out of there or something. Oh, those droids coming at me though. Oh my goodness.
I stopped the bombings. There were no casualties beyond the initial blast.
You really did it? Thank you, Lieutenant. Thank you so much. The city of Anchorhead owes you a great debt.
Excuse me, Mayor Claren. I'm sorry to interrupt, sir, but we have an urgent holocall. Someone who claims to have vital information about the bomber's identity.
What? Really? Put them through, Cone.
Hello there, Mayor Claren, sir. My name is Vanto Bazrin, and I have vital information for you regarding... I'm sorry, is that... Sergeant? Is that you? Sergeant, it's me, Fuse, from Old Mantell. Remember?
How could I forget?
I know you might not believe this, but I'm really, really glad you're here. If anyone can shut down the imps and stop the bombings in Anchorhead, it's you.
You're betraying the Empire and helping the Republic again.
Yes, please, please trust me. With my help, you can stop them.
Lieutenant, who is this guy? Can he really help us stop the bombings?
I cannot discuss this individual or my mission, sir.
Please, I don't have much time. If they catch me transmitting, they'll... It won't be good. The Imperials brought me here to design bombs. Desert planet, middle of nowhere, you know, makes sense, right? Then Colonel Gorik, the imp leader, well, he wants to test the bombs, but he won't use the empty deserts. He wanted a live testing ground. He chose Anchorhead.
That son of a... He's killing innocent people just to test your damn bombs?
You're assuming that Fuse is telling the truth.
Why would I lie? Why would I call you at all unless I wanted to help, right? It wouldn't make sense. As soon as I found out, I told Gorik I wouldn't do it. Never. So his men locked me up in here. Gorik's afraid of Tavis, or he would have just killed me. Only you can stop Gorik now. Let me help you. Let me tell you who's putting the bomb droids together.
Keep talking. I'm listening.
A group of Geonosians is building the bomb droids. When each batch is finished, they're sent to the coordinates that Gorik provides. The Geonosians are holed up somewhere outside Anchorhead, but I don't know where the exact location is. Guards are coming now. I have to hide the transmitter before I'm caught. Fuse out.
Do you know anything about these Geonosians, Mayor Claren?
The Geonosians Fuse mentioned, a big gang of them, moved into an abandoned town nearly 2 months ago. They haven't been a problem, no worse than scavengers. We never imagined they were involved in the bombings.
Can you tell me anything about these people?
Well, they aren't exactly people, for starters. They're creepy insectoids with a knack for tech. I can't believe I didn't think of them before. If you kill the Geonosians' leader, it should put a stop to all of this. But there are so many, getting in won't be easy.
You don't think we should try to talk this one out, Mayor?
If you think you can talk them down, be my guest. But if what Fuse said is true, then I'm not interested in a peaceful resolution. Good luck out there, Lieutenant.
Alright, we got a new gear upgrade. Yeah, 2 Master for 30 tech. I'll take that. So we're off to the Geonosian headquarters, and... One thing I've learned in life is if somebody says trust them, that's a good hint to a reason not to. Honest people usually don't need to say things like that. Okay, it looks like we're going to have to get on a speeder, so I'll go ahead and cut out here and bring you guys back in once we land. Okay, we made it. The speeder, you can't really see it, but it's right there. We're headed north. And yeah, I'm kind of wondering if this might be an ambush. I'm pretty sure it's not, but yeah, never know. He's already been a traitor once. Well, we're going to get a whole lot of experience just by exploring. Might even level up before we get to the cave. No, it says it's a cave. I think it's just a hideout. No, it's a warehouse. Okay. Geonosian warehouse. I can't remember what the Geonosians look like. He said they were insectoid. I remember it in Star Wars Galaxies, but I'm drawing a blank as to what the character actually looked like. Or the, I should say, the species. Oh, okay, those guys. The Bugmen. Yeah, I forgot about those guys. And there's quite a few of them. Maybe we can sneak in here. Not too much farther to go. It looks like it's right here. Okay, so we're supposed to be here to investigate and or talk them down or kill them. Most likely it's going to be a killing them. Let's see if we can find... Is that something to click on? No. What is all this? Looks like some type of serum, injecting serum. I wonder if that turns them...
What I'm saying, my dear friends, is that the latest objective was not destroyed.
Have any other plans you'd like to share with us?
Republic soldiers! Eliminate them, Kovacs! At once!
Well, so much for a peaceful meeting here. I thought we were going to have the
gotcha
option to not be fighting. Maybe I spoke the wrong words there. Oh boy, you better help us out, Havoc Squad. Really? All the way back to the mayor? I want to look around just a little bit more. Yeah, that the needles that we saw. I'm wondering if it works kind of like the rat ghoul disease where you can just turn somebody into a Geonosian. Or if maybe they just use that for medical purposes. No, I don't see anything too exciting. They got a lot of weapons, that's for sure. Okay, let's go ahead and use our quick travel, and I think it was right there. We'll go right here. I think I was fairly close. That was a pretty short meeting that we had. I was hoping that would be a little bit longer as well. And I probably chose the wrong option. You know, I was really expecting a peaceful outcome from all that, but no, we didn't get one. At least not the way I chose.
I'm so sorry, Mayor Claren. I never imagined it would come to this, you know? Innocent people dead, all because of my designs. I was so stupid.
Well, you're working for the right side now, okay, buddy? We're going to put a stop to this.
The Geonosians were definitely working with the imps.
I know, it's... Well, thanks for trusting me after everything that's happened. I really do want to help. Colonel Gorick is, he isn't pleased about you being here, Lieutenant. He has the entire operation on high alert.
I think it's time for you to tell me where you are, Fuse.
Well, I would, but there's a problem. You see, the base's location is a total secret. I have no idea where we are. The only people who have the base's coordinates are Gorick's commando teams. You'll have to hit one of those teams to get the coordinates.
Just point me in the right direction and I'll move out.
When the guards were talking earlier, I overheard them mention a commando team stationed in a cave near the Sand People's settlements. The commandos were deployed to test some of my designs on the Sand People. Mines, booby traps, that kind of thing. So the Sand People are, you know, pretty riled up right now.
I'm basically committing suicide by going out there. Is that about right?
Well, it might be suicidal for anybody else, but not for you. It may not be long before Gorick decides to pull out entirely, Lieutenant. He's worried that more Republic reinforcements are coming. So, try to reach the cave and get the coordinates off the commandos quickly, before the opportunity is gone.
Good luck out there. You'll need it.
Get the coordinates off the commandos. He couldn't find a way to transmit a signal from his location. Alright. Works for me, but that'll work. Yeah, we're going to have to take another speeder. I just kind of wanted to see where we're going. Okay. Most likely that same speeder, unless I can find one that's maybe a little bit closer. But we'll go ahead and cut out here and I'll bring you guys back in once I find it. Okay, we touched down. I was right. There is another speeder in this area, so we're just going to head straight north. And by straight north, I probably mean not so much straight. Well, it looks like we might be able to go straight north. There is a road. Question is, I don't know if I'm supposed to be on the road or if maybe I'm supposed to be up there, but we're going to find out. There's those Womp Rats. You know, that's another difference between this and Star Wars Galaxies. Well, Star Wars does have some small ones, the baby ones, but they've also got some that are rather large. Probably about the half size of that Bantha. Definitely a lot larger than a human. Yeah, it feels like I'm not going the right way. Well, there is a road right there, so let's keep on going, see if we can catch up on that road. Yeah, it looks like we can go up here and turn around and then go back. Or are we supposed to go through the tunnel, maybe? Nope, can't go that way. Yeah, Star Wars Galaxies, it may be a game that I might bring to the channel, but I'm not sure how long I'd be able to do it. It's an old game, therefore it's got a lot of mechanics that are severely outdated, and I don't think a lot of people would enjoy that. But you never know, I could be wrong. Alright, how much farther we got? Oh, looks like it's on the other side. Yeah, I'm not too sure about this. I might end up having to cut out and bring you guys back in when I find... Oh, there it is right there. Awesome. If we can manage to get in there without dying. Okay, I think we made her. Alright, hop to it, Havoc Squad.
Gotcha.
Wow, one shot almost killed him. Not as impressive as it has been though. One shot and he was pretty much taken out like a group of people. Now it's one shot almost takes out one person. No, he's still alive. There we go. I guess we could use a little bit of healing. Looks like he's starting to take some damage as well. He might actually get to be a healer for a while. I like that. So we need a few more kills. I'll try not to get too close to that. Let's actually go ahead and take out this guy. Alright, one more. Maybe these guys will count. Yeah, there's one right there. I wonder if that green beam that's coming out of the gun right there, I wonder if that changes with your crystals. Is that where I want to be? That light kind of looks like maybe we could... No, can't click on it. This guy down below us, I guess. Yep, he's right there. I'm gonna wait on there. Actually, let's just, there we go, brought him back.
Halt! Identify yourself immediately.
Havoc Squad, pleased to meet you.
What, I thought Havoc Squad was on our side now, Surge?
We'll figure it out when they're dead. Open fire.
That didn't go as planned. Alright, let him have it, Jorgen, because I'm running out here.
Surrender! I surrender! Please!
All I need is the location of your base. Tell me that and you can go.
Base. Base coordinates. Here, on this data... data pad. Please. Mercy. Mercy.
You're free to go, soldier. Thank you for your cooperation.
Thank you. Thank you.
Lieutenant. Lieutenant, can you hear me? This is Oleg Klarin. Are you there, Lieutenant?
Has something come up?
Fuse just called. He said Colonel Gorick is pulling out. He's going to run for it, Lieutenant. That scum killed dozens of innocent people for his tests. Those people deserve justice. Their families deserve justice. Please hurry, Lieutenant. Gorick has to pay for what he's done.
I'll move out immediately, sir.
You've got him on the run. Now finish him off. Good luck, Lieutenant. Clarin, Clarin out. Right.
Alright. Is that actually an upgrade? Awesome. Yeah, our gear was getting a little bit shabby there. So where is this guy actually located? Alright, I'll make my way to the speeder and bring you guys back. Alrighty, we touched down. It doesn't look like it's too far away. That is where we're headed. And just by from what I've seen so far, it looks like there is a ton of quests on this planet for the Republics. There were quite a few for the Imperial, but just by looking at it, I'd say there's probably more for the Republic. So this planet, whenever we get around to actually doing it, that's going to take a few episodes. And speaking of that, I'm going to try to make this into one video, but if it gets over to be like, say, an hour long, then I probably will divide it into two segments. I'm hoping that we'll get it all done in one episode, though. There's that balloon for the Datacron. Looks like. Let's actually bring up... Yeah, that would be the balloon for the Datacron. Yeah, even this planet feels different when you're playing on the Republic side. At least it does for me. I think those are the communication towers. I think we're actually pretty close to the, oh, what is that big old worm in the ground? I can't remember what it was called. It'll come to me, probably after the episode's over. Yeah, we got an achievement, one for exploring it, and then the other one was diving down into the mouth of it and dying. Yeah, we made her. We're supposed to be looking for a fuse.
You're done.
No, you get away from me. Ah, he hit me. Wow. There's gonna be quite a few guys in here. Oh boy. Get away from me. So we can line of sight some of that stuff. Let Jorgen handle it. I guess we could buff up. Forgot all about that. Yeah, interrogation drone. Yeah, you stay away from me. I don't want to be interrogated. Alright, four more. Let's actually sick him on the boss over there. We'll take out this guy. It takes me a while to kill stuff. To be expected as a healer class, though. Or I should say healer spec, not class. There he is. Looks like he's all by himself.
Lieutenant, you made it just in time. Gorik called for a full-scale evacuation. He's already at the hangar in the back of the base overseeing the evacuation, and he has my bomb designs with him. Please. You have to get to the landing area and stop Gorik before he escapes with my bomb designs.
Am I just supposed to leave you here?
I'm clearly not going anywhere, Lieutenant. After you've taken down Gorik, you can...
Warning. Warning. Self-destruct sequence initialized. All personnel must evacuate to the hangar area immediately. This is not a drill. Countdown sequence initialized. Warning. Warning. Facility detonation imminent.
Oh no, we're too late. The entire base, it's gonna be vaporized. We're out of time.
There must be some way to shut down the self-destruct sequence.
You'd have to go to the command center to cancel the detonation, and... Well, you could even unlock myself from there. But by the time you reach the command center and stop the explosion, Gorik will have escaped with my bomb designs. That can't happen.
I'm sure I can stop the explosion and get Gorik if I move fast enough.
No. No, you have to leave me. By the time you cancel the self-destruct, Gorik will be long gone. Please, there isn't time to argue. It's down to me or the bomb designs, and... well, there's only one good choice there.
I've made my choice, and I'm getting you out of here.
Forget about me! Stop Gorik! Keep the Empire from getting my designs, that's all that matters!
Today isn't your day to die, Fuse.
Please, Lieutenant, don't let Gorik escape just for me. Please don't do it.
So, I actually really don't have the... okay. I really don't have the choice. Maybe we'll have an alternative choice. We'll see. I'm leaning towards trusting him. Don't know if I'd trust him with a gun quite yet, but he's getting trustworthy. Okay, now we can open his cell. Yeah, I was kind of expecting this to be a ambush. Of course, now watch. I opened up my mouth too fast, and it is going to be an ambush here eventually. Okay, so the controls are... well, yeah, they did say that we had to do that first. Alright. But, there's two of us here, you know. Jorgen could have ran upstairs and dealt with that while I dealt with this, or vice versa.
Lieutenant, I guess I should thank you. You saved my life after everything.
Sorry you're so disappointed.
Well, I'm still not so sure it was the right thing to do, but it... well, thanks. Still, it... well, it's hard knowing my designs might be hurting innocent people. I helped Gorik, helped a monster. It's unforgivable.
What you've done may be unforgivable, but you can still be useful.
Useful. I guess that's something. Okay then, let's, go. Consider me officially surrendered, Lieutenant. I'll stay where you can see me.
It's a long trip back to Coruscant.
I'm ready, Lieutenant.
Squad, hold up! Get me a solid perimeter ASAP! You must be the commander of Havoc Squad. I'm Lieutenant Tasser, sir. 43rd Advanced Recon Squad.
If you came to help, you're a little late.
Yes, sir. That's definitely the impression we got coming in. Apologies. General Garza rerouted us from a 2-week sightseeing op on Ryloth to assist you, Lieutenant. Looks like you've already taken care of things, though.
The mission was a complete success.
Garza mentioned a possible prisoner for us to haul back to Coruscant. Is this the guy Garza was talking about?
Take this man to Coruscant immediately.
Understood, Lieutenant.
I guess I'll... see you around, then. Good luck.
Good luck to you too, Fuse.
All right, people, let's move out. I want a full sweep through this facility for intel. Good meeting you, Lieutenant. Maybe we'll see you around later. Let's go, people!
Kinda want some more background. You know, I didn't really trust him. Now I've got other people here that I'm not... you know, we never met them. So we're off to talk to the mayor. Do we have quick travel? Oh, so close. Okay, well, I'll go ahead and walk back, and we'll see you guys back when we get to the mayor. Alright, we made her back here. Let's go ahead and talk to the mayor.
Lieutenant, you made it! Please, have a seat. Tell me what happened. Was your mission against the Imperials a success?
I can't discuss the details.
Yes, of course. I understand. Top secret mission, of course. Well, could you at least tell me about Fuse? I mean, did you rescue him from the Imperials?
All of the details about Fuse are classified, I'm afraid.
Shame. I really took a liking to him. Be nice to know if he made it out safe. So, your general called while you were gone. I filled her in on what I knew. Nice lady. Stern, though.
General Garza is an exemplary officer.
She definitely seemed to know what's what. Comes with the job, I guess. Anyway, she wants you to call her from your ship before you take off. She was pretty insistent about it, actually. I hope there's nothing wrong.
There's no predicting with Garza.
You accomplished some great things here. I can't imagine she's anything but pleased. Well, Lieutenant, the people of Anchorhead owe you an incredible debt. You've saved countless lives from a threat we never could have imagined. I managed to scrape together a small reward for you. It's the least we could do to thank you.
I really appreciate it, Mayor Claren.
Extra credits always come in handy. Never know when command might start making cutbacks.
I'm just glad we could give you something for your hard work, especially if it helps you help more people down the line. So, I guess this is where we part ways. It's been a real pleasure having you here, Lieutenant. An honor. We'll never forget what you've done for us.
The Republic prides itself on protecting the innocent.
Well, be sure the Republic knows how much we appreciate the help. Good luck, Lieutenant. You'll always be welcome in Anchorhead.
Well, there's a side of Jordan I've never seen before. I couldn't believe he actually said that. Alright, looks like we're back on the way to our ship, so I'll see you guys when we get up there. Okay, we made her back to our ship, and we kept our mouth shut, so hopefully the General is going to be happy with us. Let's see what this guy has to say.
Welcome back, Master. Your vessel is in flawless condition, naturally.
Thank you, sir. I can't believe that the Republic side, they never talk unless you actually click on them. Or at least so far. I've been in the ship probably about a half a dozen times now, and he's never said anything. Alright, let's go ahead and get our holo communicator up, or our holo terminal.
Lieutenant, thank you for calling. From what I hear, you've been very busy. We have quite a bit to discuss. First, congratulations on stopping the bombings in Anchorhead. Mayor Claren was both impressed and grateful. Well done.
Glad I could make a difference.
You've represented the Republic very well in this. Good job. I also understand that you not only located Fuse, but routed an entire Imperial research facility in the process. Lieutenant Tasser filed his report only moments ago, actually. I'm sorry he and his men couldn't arrive sooner.
Lieutenant Tasser was very helpful, General.
I'm glad to hear it. Tasser reports that you brought Fuse in alive and without resistance. Cardin will be pleased. He had begun to doubt our commitment to bring the Havoc traders in safely.
I never could have pulled this off without him.
Yes, Mayor Claren indicated that as well. I'm pleased that Fuse could see the error of his ways. What about the bomb designs that Fuse created for the Imperials? Were you able to retrieve a copy?
The Imperials fled with the designs while I was saving Fuse.
I'm glad you managed to bring Fuse in alive, Lieutenant, but letting those designs slip away will carry a heavy cost. Still, your mission was largely successful. You are to be congratulated.
Largely successful. So she's not 100% happy, but she is happy. And we now know that Fuse is where he should be, so that's a good thing. And I guess we'll go ahead and wrap up here, and next time we're off to, was it Alderaan? Indeed. So we'll go ahead and hook that up. Look forward to sharing that experience with you guys. Until next time, have a good one.